Okay, I figured I'd do a little video on this new knife that I picked up. I don't really need another knife, but they're on, like, really cheap at Canadian Tire once in a while, so it's kind of like, yeah, I'll give it a try. And, so these, well, they're still on sale right now, but they're the Gerber Ripstop II, which I think it's the bigger version of the, because there's like a, they make like a paraframe as well, which is like a 1 and 2, and I think one's bigger than the other, something or other. Anyway, like there's a similar idea. They got like the steel, the frame or grip to it, and so anyway, so Canadian Tire says it should be regular price. It's like $51.99, so $52, which I don't think, but they're on for $12.99, which is actually cheaper than, like, if you watch other people's videos, like in the States and stuff, that what people pay for this one or the paraframe one or the, like, they pay more for that than $12.99. So I was like, well, what the hell, I'll give it a try. I'm a sucker for these sort of around $10 kind of knives. But so I already cut that out of the packaging here. So we got Ripstop 2. It's 5CR15 stainless, which is sort of a semi-low-end Chinese stainless steel. It's, I guess it's similar to, like, I don't know, 420 high-carbon steel or something or other. It's kind of hard. You go on the internet and look up, like, oh, what's this steel, like, similar to, and I guess it's used in knives quite a lot, like sort of more inexpensive knives. It's got a plain edge, because some of these have like a half, like a combo, like serrated, and then sort of like 50-50, which I don't like serrations. Like, they work for some stuff, but then when they get dull, they're kind of a, it's like, no. Anyway, it's a folding knife, got a frame lock, it's got a pocket clip, there's nearly anything else on the back here. Designed and engineered in Oregon. Made in China. I got a 25-year warranty or something or other. This is their 5CR15 MOV stainless steel. So anyway. And this one's sort of, I don't know if it's a Canada only thing or what. Like, if you look up videos on YouTube of this, and it seems like the plain edge one is harder to find, but then there's the way, like, most of them have like a thumb stud here and this little sort of nail nick ish thing here is actually a hole on most of them, so I don't know if that's weird. But, and it's got this weird thing around the pivot, which looks kind of like, I don't know, like it's a hubcap off of a 1960s pickup truck or something. I don't know. Like, it's kind of strange. So you get all steel construction with a bunch of these holes cut in it to sort of make it lighter. It's 3.5 ounces it weighs. You get all this skeletonizing on this side, and there's your frame lock there, and your pocket clip. It's only on one side, which I don't really care. So this is basically two hand open. You gotta, on this one anyway. The other ones, you can kind of open them with your thumb, but I don't know why they do that here. But, and you can see the frame lock. This one engages quite a bit. It's got a little bit of wiggle side to side and a little bit up and down. Like, when you engage the lock and you push on it, the lock kind of wiggles a little bit, like it's not strong enough to stay where it is or something, but it's securely locked, it seems, but it's just kind of strange. And there's this little tail on the clip here that I guess is designed to keep you from pushing this lock too far. There's other knives have little things they put on the side, or so you don't push this too far and sort of like bend it too far kind of deal. So And I also noticed when you close it, like there's a little detent on it that kind of holds the blade in. You can push that in, like it doesn't want to go in the hole. Like either the hole doesn't line up, or this frame lock part is too weak, or so then you try to open it, see, so it gives it a little bit more resistance, but you gotta kind of push it in its own, in the hole there. So anyway, those are sort of things that are sort of just, I guess, it's quality control problems that, like, when it's $13, you can kind of like, yeah, okay, that's fine. But like, if it was $52, then it would be like, that's not acceptable. But it cuts good. It was quite sharp when I got it. I touched it up with a little Speedy Sharp. I use it on, you know, I didn't hauled it around for the last few days and use it on different stuff, and it seems to cut fine. It looks kind of nice. I don't know. Look at the grip is kind of, I don't know. It's not the best thing ever to feel the hold in your hand, but it's, there's no sharp edges or anything. Like it's, but it's for, I don't think you really want to bear down on it too hard. It's kind of thin and whatever, but it's fairly, you know, robust thing anyway. So. And I kind of like this, I guess it's kind of like a bead blasted kind of finish. Like it's not highly polished, so it doesn't show like fingerprints, stuff like this. So it does look kind of nice that way, because nothing worse than these really high polished knives, and then they look like ass, like right quick. It's kind of annoying, I guess, but it's, you know, for on sale, it's a decent knife, and you could give it to somebody as a gift or something, and it seems like it'd be do most things. Like I've used it for when I was eating stuff, cutting up food and things, or, you know, cutting up stuff to make food, or cutting up food that I, you know, like take away or whatever. But and there's one thing I kind of like about it, like I don't know if other people kind of notice this or not, when you're like, you know, cutting up your food with something, and then you set the knife down. Some knives, when you set them down, the blade goes into the, I think, let's see if this one here, I think this one does it. You know, like this one, it kind of, some of them, they sit down and then the blade touches the table. So then if you have something on it, you're cutting up something and then it gets gunk on the table or something. This one, you can set it either way and it won't do that. Like if you, say if I'm just using a knife by itself, I cut with my left hand, but if I'm using a fork and a knife, then I use it the other way. So you can set it this side and the blade won't touch the cutting surface, and this way as well, it won't. Anyway, I kind of find that as kind of a good thing. I don't know if anybody else notice that or gives a crap, I don't know. But so overall, I think for what I paid, they're a decent little knife. Steel seems to work all right, but it's, you know, it's soft, so it's easy to sharpen, but you can get a pretty decent edge on it. And anyway, the pocket clip works. It's not super springy, like I've had it in my pocket and it's fallen out and stuff, but it's in that little weird thing with the thing not holding it, but it doesn't open in your pocket. And if you carry it on this side, like on the right side, you know, if the blade did come out and you put your hand in your pocket, it's not gonna get you anyway. So, and it's all, you know, open construction, so you can use it for whatever and get crap all over it, and then it's easy to clean out. It's got the nylon washers, if I didn't mention, which, whatever. But the rest of it's all steel. There's a couple different screws here and stuff, but I heard that these, most of these knives are hard to take apart anyway, so, which I don't really know why you would want to take the thing apart. And you, the clip, you can't move it anyway, so you might as well just leave it where it is. It is kind of weird though, like it's got these kind of these weird screws that kind of, instead of having a dome headed screw, they kind of just sort of flat, but they're kind of like, it looked like a shape of a screw that should go into almost like a counter's sunk hole or something, but whatever. Just maybe that's all they had at the Chinese factory that they where they made it. But anyway, I think it's a pretty decent looking little knife, and so I figured to do a video because it seems like it's a little bit different than the ones you can get in the States. So anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll talk to you later.